Hello students, in this video I am going to discuss about the arint function. So let's understand how does arint work. So to get the result of the arint function, first of all you need to look at the decimal part of the given number, okay. If the decimal part is greater or equal to 0.5, then you are going to take the seal value of the given number, okay. If it is less than equal to 0.5, not less than equal to, if it is less than 0.5, then you are going to take the floor value of the given number, okay. And the return type of arint is double. So let's see a few problems. 1.5, so the decimal part is 0.5. So we are going to take the seal value of 1.5. So seal value of 1.5 will be 2.0. So the answer is 2.0. Let's look at the next number, 1.49. So 0.49, it is less than 0.5, okay. So 0.49 is less than 0.5. So the answer will be floor of the given value. So the floor of 1.49, the floor 0.149 will be 1.0. So the answer is 1.0. Next, we have got 1.51 this time. So 51, it is greater than 0.5. So the answer is seal of the given number. So seal of 1.5 will be 2.0. Next number is 1.6, the decimal part is 0.6, 0.6 is greater than 0.5. So the answer will be the seal value of the given number. So the seal value of 1.6 will be 2.0. So the answer is 2.0. Now this 2.5, it's a special case, and this one minus 2.5, it's a special case. So I'll talk about it later, okay. First let us see the negative numbers. So minus 1.5, in case of negative numbers, students listen carefully, in case of negative numbers you are going to follow the same process, okay. You are going to follow the same process that you did for the positive numbers, and at last you'll put a negative sign before the answer. So 1.5, okay, minus 1.5. So ignore the negative sign, ignore the negative sign and just consider 1.5. so we have got 0.5 in the decimal, so the answer will be seal value. So answer is 2.0. And before this 2.0, we will put a negative sign, that is the answer. Then next is minus 1.49. So forget the negative sign, just focus on the decimal part, 0.49. 0.49 is less than 0.5. Since it's less than 0.5, we are going to take the floor value. So the floor value of 1.49 is 1.0, and then I'll put a negative sign. So the answer is minus 1.0. Similarly, minus 1.51, 0.51 is greater than 0.5. So answer will be seal of the given number. So the seal value will be 2.0, and we'll put a negative sign before the answer. So the answer is minus 2.0. Then we have got minus 1.6, minus 1.6. So 0.6, we have got a greater number then 0.5, okay. So the answer will be seal value of the given number. So the seal value of 1.6 will be 2.0, and at last we'll put the negative sign. So the answer is minus 2.0, okay. Now let's talk about the special case. So whenever the decimal part is exactly 0.5, like in this one, here, here, and here. So in all these four cases, the decimal part is exactly 0.5. So in this case, you'll apply the rule, okay? Since we have got 0.5, so the answer should be seal value, right? And if we see the seal value of 1.5, that is 2.0, okay? So since this is even, since the result of the seal value is 2.0, that is an even number, so we'll keep this will be our final answer, okay? But let's consider 2.5. so this 2.5, if we take the seal value, okay, I told you that 0.5 or greater or equal to 0.5 will take the seal value, okay? So 2.5, the seal value of 2.5 will be 3.0, but since this is odd, we are not going to take this value, we will rather take the floor value. So the floor value 2.5 comes between 2.0 and 3.0. So the seal value is an odd number, okay? So we are not going to take this, we will rather take this floor value, which is 2.0, and it is even. So the answer is 2.0. similarly, -1.5, okay? So -1.5, ignore the negative sign, as I have explained before. 0.5, the result will be seal value of 1.5, that is 2.0, which is even. So we'll just take the seal value. This is our correct answer, -2.0, okay? Let's talk about -2.5. So -2.5, ignore the negative sign, 0.5 is there, that means we have to take the seal value will be 3.0, but since this is odd, we will not consider this and we'll take the floor value. So the floor value of 2.5 will be 2.0. So the answer is -2.0, since we have got a negative sign. So the answer is -2.0. I hope you have understood how our int works. So I'll stop here. Thank you.